expressed that United Research Forum is organizing such a scientific webinar amid COVID-19 pandemic on virology, infectious disease, and COVID-19 webinar 2021. In this seminar, I am going to represent a topic which is a research based upon the bioinformatics studies entitled Exploring the Phytochemical-Based Inhibition of PONA1 from Mycobacterium tuberculosis by Molecular Docking, Dynamic Simulation and ADMET Studies. Before going to the studies, this is the background. We know we are within the pandemic and this is running over more than 1.5 years. And there are several kind of infections such as fungus, bacterial, including tuberculosis, which is caused by Mycobacterium tuberculosis amid COVID-19 pandemic, beside COVID-19 pandemic. Withania somniferae is a plant. It is known as a very interesting medicinal plant. The components or phytochemicals have been extracted from its different parts, actually from and mainly from its roots, and applied on Mycobacterium, tested in vitro as well as in vivo. And very interesting results have been published by different authors worldwide. But this is an in silico-based study. We have chosen some phytochemicals from Withania somnifera plant and interacted with a protein, which is a penicillin binding protein, PONA, from Mycobacterium tuberculosis. And interaction have been analyzed in order to express the phytochemicals of Withania somnifera in the inhibition of this protein, so that the growth of the Mycobacterium that cause tuberculosis in humans may be inhibited. And for this purpose, we have followed ligand preparation. That means the phytochemicals we have retrieved from PubChem. Protein preparation, before that we have retrieved the structure of protein PONA from PDB website. Molecular docking was done to study the interaction between the phytochemicals ligands with protein receptor or target. That means we have targeted this protein PONA from Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Then we have studied 3D interaction between them, 2D interaction between them. Thereafter, the phytochemicals were analyzed for Lipinski's RO5 rule, bioavailability radar, and ADMET prediction. That means adsorption, distribution, metabolism, excretion, and toxicity of the ligands that are studied in this study. And this is actually their drug likeness and ADMET analysis. That means the pharmacokinetic properties. And to authenticate the molecular docking study results, we have selected one that shows lower binding energy with the protein, target protein PONA, and molecular dynamic simulation for that combination were done to corroborate the study achieved from the result achieved from molecular docking. The studies include, we have utilized different types of software as well as online server, which are available freely for the bioinformatic research purposes, which is UCSF Chimera version 1.15. This is the website. Then PyMOL. These two are utilized for the interaction study between protein and ligand. OpenBubble version 3.1.1. This web server was utilized to convert from file types from one file type to another file type. Biodiversity Studio Visualizer V21.1.0.2029 was utilized for the interaction study. PKCSM as well as RCSB, these are two. PKCSM as well as ADMET web server, these are two web servers that are helpful for the pharmacokinetic analysis of the ligands that are utilized in the study. And RCSB PDB, this is a web server that I have already told, that from which we have retrieved or downloaded the protein structure utilized as a target in the study. And PubChem, from this website, we have downloaded three phytochemicals that we will show later on, and one an antibiotic kanamycin for the study against the protein target. Molecular dynamics simulation were studied using Gromax version 2021, CHARM general force field, CGEN FF. So these are the phytochemicals that can be isolated from the Somniferia uidania or Uidaneria somniferia, a medicinal plant, very active phytochemicals that are capable of inhibiting the growth of Mycobacterium in vitro, which are Viscosa lecton B. The PubChem ID is this, and then second one is Vidafarin A. This is the chemical name, and PubChem ID is like this. Another phytochemical from Uidania somniferia is Uidanolide A. This is the structure. All these are 3D structures. And this is kanamycin, the usual conventional antibiotic that may be used against tuberculosis infected patients. And this is the structure of protein, which is P1A. That means we have retrieved or downloaded from this website, RCSB, and its resolution of this structure is 1.75 angstrom, and method of preparation was X-ray diffraction. PDB ID is 5CXW, and actually this is the PONA 1 protein, which is isolated from Mycobacterium tuberculosis, and it is now in a complex with penicillin V. This is an antibiotic. This is the penicillin. These are solvent molecules which are in red dotted form, and this is the structure of protein. And before that, before the molecular docking, we have to prepare the protein structure for docking purpose. Then we have to remove the solvents, the ligand, which is penicillin here, and other ions also, so that complete protein preparation will be done in RCSB chimera. And the structural authenticity of the protein 5CXW, that means Mycobacterium tuberculosis PONA 1 protein, has been determined through Ramachandran plot analysis in PROCheck web server. Here we are seeing that no one residues of amino acids are located in the disallowed region or in generously allowed region. That means all the maximum of the amino acid residues, 286 number, which is 93.5% numbers, are located in the favored region, and additional favored region only 6.5 number yellow, and red is the most favored region. So we are seeing that if the 90% of the amino acid residues are located within the favored region, in the red region, most favored region, then it is a very good structure to be utilized as a target protein for the analysis of docking, molecular docking against different types of ligands. And here we are seeing that the percentage is 93.5%, and it is more than 90%. So this is a very good structure to be utilized as a target. And this is the structural features that we have done in this website. And this is actually the antigenic plot sequence. Here the antigenic propensity or the antigenicity profile were determined. 16 different types of profiles were found. These are the amino acid residues. And another web server also utilized. This is the sequence, amino acid sequence of Mycobacterium tuberculosis PONA 1 protein. And here we are seeing that from this web server, SVMTRIP, this web server, this is the second one. Here seven types of epitopes are found, of which one is red flag. That means it is recommended for the study for the purpose of discovery of any vaccine. And the molecular docking study, now we will follow. We have already told that the structural preparation will be done both for ligands as well as protein before the docking. And it will be done in RCSB chimera. And thereafter, we have prepared Pocket in a Pocket 10 server. That means this is a program for pocket identification in protein structure preparation. And thereafter, we have preparation a grid, the dimension which was 60 into 40 into 40 angstrom. And the center utilized from the pocket was like this. This means PONA, Mycobacterium tuberculosis protein, and this is the center utilized during docking. And this is the docked complex we have combined after single docking. That means at a time, one ligand was docked to the protein PONA1. And here we are seeing that viscosalecton, that the structural configuration already shown in the earlier slides. So viscosalecton B, blue in color here, and with furin A, yellow in color, this is the ligand, and with anolide A, this is tint in color, this whitish, and kanamycin red in color. That means we have utilized three phytochemicals, bioactive phytochemicals from the medicinal plant Withania somanifera, and one standard antibiotic, which is kanamycin. So we are seeing that all the ligands, either the antibiotic or the phytochemicals, are located in the same pocket. And now we will analyze the interaction. This is 3D interaction and 2D interaction. In the here, this is left side and right side. This is 3D interaction and 2D interaction between PONA A1 protein of Mycobacterium and withanolide A phytochemical from Withania somanifera. This is the entire protein, PONA1, and this is the ligand after docking. So this is the 3D complex, and this is 3D interaction. The amino acids in yellow colors are represented here, and this is the tint color or gray color. This is the ligand withanolide, and here this is the ligand and the amino acids resulting into the formation of different kinds of bonds in the interaction, which are conventional hydrogen bond in green color. Asparagine and serine took part in this interaction, and arginine and valine took part in the interaction for the formation of alkaline. That means these are hydrophobic bond, alkaline bonds, and carbon hydrogen bonds are also formed with the interaction between ligand and serine 398 and glycine 344. So this is the interaction, and due to such kind of interaction, we have seen that binding energy between ligand as well as the protein is very low, -10.7 kilocalorie per mole. That means the interaction is very tight and very stable due to the low binding energy. And this is the 9 different types of interaction, bond interaction, that we have already shown here listing up, and their distance, that means the bond distance are represented here, and the bond angle are very good for this. That means the ligand as well as asparagine 400. And another complex with the same protein PONA1, widafarin. This is the second ligand, and this is the widafarin in 3D structure. The amino acid interacting here are represented in written in yellow color. This is the 3D interaction. The same pocket has been utilized by this widafarin in the pocket of the PONA, as we have mentioned in the earlier for the first ligand. And this is the 2D interaction. Here the number of conventional hydrogen bonds are high compared to the previous one. That means 6 bonds here we are seeing, which are conventional hydrogen bond. On one pi alkaline bond are formed with tyrosine, and these are actually the bond. And another interesting feature, we are seeing that the binding energy for this second docked complex is slightly higher. That means the binding efficiency of the between the ligand as well as the protein is slightly low, but it is recommended because it is higher than -6.5, the recommended values. So the binding energy is -9.0 kilocalorie per mole for this complex, and these are the interacting bonds. And this is the third one, viscosalecton B. This is the viscosalecton B phytochemical from Withania somanifera. These are the interacting amino acids written in, indicated in yellow color. This is 3D interacting complex, total structure of the protein. And this is ligand located in the pocket of the protein. And this is 2D structure. Here also different types of bonds are formed, alkaline, pi alkaline, conventional hydrogen bond, carbon hydrogen bond. And the binding energy is slightly high compared to the previous one, which is -9.2 kilocalorie per mole. And these are the interacting bonds. And very strong bond is in between the ligand as well as the asparagine, because of the bond length is 2.12, that means below 2.35, I'm strong. And its angle is 140.79 degree, that means mostly near about the 180 degree. And the kanamycin, this is a standard antibiotic. The interacting amino acids are larger in number. Here different types of amino acids are presented that are interacted with the ligand. Yes, this is the kanamycin, and these are the amino acids of the PONA protein. This is the complex structure. The kanamycin is here in the pocket, and entire structure of the protein. And here we are seeing that the interesting features, salt bridges are formed with glutamic acid 382 as well as 384, total four salt bridges are formed between the interaction of the kanamycin as well as protein PONA, one from Mycobacterium tuberculosis. And large number of hydrogen bonds which are represented in green color are also formed, as well as attractive charge bond are also formed. Pi cation as well as carbon hydrogen bonds are formed, which are like this. And 18 total bonds were formed that were shown in the previous slide. And thereafter, we have chosen a very strong ligand, which is a udanolide A, because its binding energy was comparatively very low, which was minus 10.2. And that's why we have utilized the udanolide A phytochemical from Udania somnifera in the molecular dynamics simulation study, utilizing the same protein, that means PONA, one from Mycobacterium. And we have already told about the Gromex web server, CHARM general force field that were utilized in the study. MD trajectory analysis were drawn in Gromex version. Binding free energy were calculated with MMP BSA approach. This is the equation, and the selection were done in VMD UCSF Chimera version as well as Pymolin also, and Discovery Studio. This web server was utilized in the molecular docking study interaction also, as well as in MD simulation here. And this is the simulated structure. These are solvated, these are solvents, water, because of the one interesting feature of molecular dynamic simulation is to be solvated in the media. So before the study, we have solvated, and this is the structure of the protein here, and these are the solvents, and this is the 3D interaction. Three amino acids are interacted because of solvation. Different types of salt molecules, that means water molecules, have been found in the interaction between udanolide and PONA. Beside the amino acid of the PONA A1 protein, only three amino acids here: isoleucine 371 that form the alkaline bond, and glutamine 544. This amino acid residue formed the conventional hydrogen bond, and carbon hydrogen bond is also formed due to the interaction between udanolide as well as PONA A protein. This is the amino acid residue glycine that were interacted to form carbon hydrogen bond. And these are the 15 number of different types of proteins that were formed between the salt, that means water molecules, and ligand, as well as amino acid molecules and ligand. And here we have drawn the configuration, that means the graphs of root mean square deviation of the ligand. This is the 4-digit symbol of the ligand, and this is the PONA1 protein, and this is the complex, that means ligand udanolide A, as well as the protein PONA1 from Mycobacterium tuberculosis. And this is the complex, and the root mean square deviation is for the complex is 0.15 nanometer. For ligand, it is 0.06 nanometer, and for protein, it is 0.14 nanometer. And this is the root mean square fluctuation. Here, the fluctuating phase is extended from this point to lower point, this one. So the fluctuation RMSF are represented in this figure, and SASA. This is the solvent accessible surface area. Because of the solvation of the ligand and protein during molecular docking, simultaneous study, large number of molecules were emerged within the solvent. And here we are seeing that this area is 160.11 nanometer square. That means the protein ligand complex were emerged within the solvent. And this is free energy of solvation calculation for the complex. That means ligand with analyte A as well as PONA1 protein. This is the complex. And this energy was distributed in this graphical structure. And the average was 54.76 kilojoule per mole. And here we are seeing that non-bonded short range column CSR. This is CSR. This kind of energy was minus 1.14 kilojoule per one. And another LJSR, which is Leonard Jones non-bonded short range LJSR. The value of this kind of energy is minus 54.27 kilojoule per mole. And this is always for the non-bonded interaction between protein PONA one as well as the with analyte one doc complex. This blue structure, this is for the protein ligand complex, and this red structure, this is for the single protein to depict the CSR and LJSR in complex. And the total free energy in this interaction were like this, minus 110.17 kilojoule. And how we have achieved this CSR value to this minus 1.14 kilojoule per ml, LJSR minus 54.27 kilojoule per ml, and free energy of solvation minus 54.76 kilojoule per mole. So that in total the value is free energy of binding, that means in docking, molecular docking simulation, the value is minus 110.17 kilojoule per ml. And now we are going for ADMET analysis, pharmacokinetic properties of the ligands. We have followed Lipinski rule, bioavailability radar, as well as ADMET analysis. This is for kanamycin. We are seeing that the value of bioavailability score is very low for kanamycin, 0.17, though we know that this is a very good antibiotic against mycobacterium and other bacterial infection. Because we are seeing that this drug followed the Lipinski rule with only two violations among four. That means rotatable bond, hydrogen bond acceptor is 15, that means higher than 10, and lower donor is higher than 11. But the molecular weight is 500. So only two violations were seen in kanamycin. And there was no skin sensitivity and hepatotoxicity as well. It was EMS toxicity negative. That means no carcinogenic interaction are found with kanamycin. So it is a good standard antibiotic for utilization of different types of bacterial infection. And this is the first viscosalecton B phytochemical from Oidania somnifera medicinal plant. Here we are seeing that bioavailability score is very high, which is 0.55. That means it is orally bioavailable, and all the criteria of bioavailability radar generation, lipophilicity, size, polarity, solubility, flexibility, and saturation are located in the pink region. That means in acceptable region. So the structure is very useful as very useful in the preparation of ligand of drug against mycobacterium or other infection. And this is another service ADMET. We are seeing that the viscosalecton is EMS toxicity negative, as well as there is no hepatotoxicity as skin as well, and skin sensitization. So it is a very good phytochemical ligand to be utilized against the treatment of bacterial infection, including mycobacterium tuberculosis. This is second one. Similarly, the bioavailability score is 0.55, and it can be orally bioavailable and utilized as a ligand, and the values are within the pink region. And there was no toxicity, hepatotoxicity, or skin sensitization, and it was negative to EMS toxicity with the farin. And the last one, with analyte A, that showed very low binding energy. That means the interaction between the protein and ligand. This ligand was very stable with bioavailability score 0.55. That means it is orally bioavailable. And here we are also seeing that the values of lipophilicity, size, polarity, solubility, effectivity, and saturation are all lie within the pink region, and that's why it is a very good bio displaying bioavailability and the eosinophilic A, and there was no toxicity, hepatotoxicity or skin sensitization, as well it was negative to EMS test. And here we are seeing that when we consider for Lipinski rule of 5, molecular weight is below 500 milligram per ml, and log p value which is below 5, and the donor acceptor hydrogen bond is less than 10, 6, and the donor hydrogen bond number is less than 5. So all the criteria utilized in the Lipinski's rule are obeyed by this eosinophilic compared to the other two phytochemicals from the same plant. So all these ligands were displayed the characteristic features that obeyed Lipinski's rule of 5, displaying their features to be utilized as a bioavailable ligand molecules to be utilized in the preparation of drug against different types of infection, including Mycobacterium tuberculosis. And this is the boiled egg features that are drawn compared to the W log P in the y-axis and TPSA value. Here we are seeing that canamycin are out of range region, and viscosa lactone B with the farin A and eosinophilide are located within the white region of the egg. So due to their location within the white region, these can be absorbed in the intestine very easily, and there are no molecules, that means the phytochemicals or the canamycin, within this yellow region of the egg. So the blood brain barrier availability is chance of blood brain barrier availability is less, and PGP enzyme action for all ligands are positive because these are blue in color, and PGP, that means all are not applicable, that means these are positive. No red color spots are found in their location. And ultimately the conclusion, based upon the binding energy which are for all were less than minus 6.5, that means the binding affinity were first eosinophilic less than viscosa lactone B, less than vidafarin A, and less than canamycin. That means the binding energy was highest for canamycin and lowest for eosinophilic A. So compared to the canamycin, all the phytochemicals from the medicinal plant Eosinia somnifera are higher, and affinity between the ligands as well as the protein is very good. So molecular docking and dynamics simulation studies authenticated the PONA1 target protein inhibition by bioactive phytochemicals from Eosinia somnifera. Eosinophilic A displayed best affinity to PONA1 protein compared to other Eosinia somnifera phytochemicals and canamycin that we have already discussed. Stable protein ligand complex formation was due to high binding affinities of the ligands to the target protein. That means the binding free energy by MMPBSA is, that we have already shown in the previous discussion, the value is minus 110.17 kilojoule per mole. The phytochemicals had higher bioavailability score 0.55 compared to the canamycin, that was for 0.17, and found fulfilling the most drug likeness characteristics as per the Lipinski's rule. Both binding energy and bioavailability of a phytochemical might play crucial role in determining its biological activity under in vivo environmental condition. So the Eosinia somnifera phytochemicals that we have utilized in this study may be useful for the preparation of drug with further studies in vitro as well as in vivo to confirm the activity of the phytochemicals against Mycobacterium tuberculosis, causing tuberculosis in human. Ultimately, I acknowledge Virology, Infectious Disease and COVID-19 Webinar 2021 Organizing Committee, organized by United Research Forum, for the recognition of my research and supporting me for this presentation. Thank you. Thank you again to the organizer and all the participants that are who are with me for listening. And now I am waiting for further interaction.